Hello everybody, welcome to Classic Education YouTube channel. Myself Mahesh Pundibij, a faculty member for UPSC aspirants in Classic IAS and KAS Academy Dharwad. So today we are just going to have some introduction about CSAT examination. So now on Sunday we are going to have CSAT examination, that is UPSC examination, and there is one paper called as a CSAT. Now what is CSAT? CSAT is a civil services aptitude test. Now here we have three main parts: maths, reasoning and English comprehension. You see, this exam is of 200 marks and we have 2 hours of time, and each question will have 2.5 marks and there is a negative marking in the ratio 3:1. That means if you make 3 questions wrong and 1 question correct, then whatever marks you have gained in one question, that will be lost because you have made 3 questions. That is 0.833 is the negative. Now you see, minimum qualification. Now if you take out of out marks also, okay, it is not going to give any additional boost for your final selection, but we have to qualify this exam. And to qualify this exam, we have to take 66.66 marks, or you can round figure it to 67, but as 2.5 marks are there, so it will become around 67.5 if you take, but minimum is 66.66 marks. Okay. Now, as I told you that here there are three main subjects, okay, maths, reasoning and English. English comprehensions will be there. So year by year, when you have observed the question papers from 2015, because from 2015 this CSAT was made in qualifying nature. Now we will be having, every year we get different number of questions. Now if you see in the last years, that is in 2020, from maths only 42 questions had appeared. Okay, so it varies. There is no fixed scheduled in between this, but we will have questions from these three subjects. Now what suggestions I have for you people is, whenever you go into the examination, you see we have 2 hours of time, and in this 2 hours of time we have to cross this mark. That should be our main focus. And when we are crossing this mark, when we are to cross this mark, what we have to do, we have to select those questions which are easier for us. And first we should come in the safe zone. So for that reason, what we have to do, we have to attempt those questions which are very easy for us. Now for example, in the previous year, if you just see in the 2020 examination, there was one simple question: the product of two numbers is 21 and the sum is 10. Now to this question, we don't need maximum time to solve this question. It was asked in the form of data sufficiency type question. So such questions need less time, and such type of questions we have to do at the first. I am not telling you that you do only maths first or reasoning or English, you do any subject which you want. But you see to it that, because some students are strong in maths, some are strong in reasoning, some are good in English. So whichever subject you are strong in, you go through that. And after that, we will be having a target setting. Okay, we say we will be having some target setting. So what we will do, that in 1 hour, the first hour, or after 1 hour 20 minutes, we see to it that we have to take care that around at least 35 to 40 questions are being attempted, and the accuracy here should be high. Then after that, whatever time is left with 40 minutes or 45 minutes, at that time you spend the time on those questions where you are doubtful with 2 options, because there are some questions where when we read the question, we will be confused between 2 options. We will eliminate 2 options, but remaining 2 options, out of that we will be having doubt. So in this case, what we have to do, that 45 minutes or that 40 minutes of the time we will spend there. And here I have given a small strategy. Okay, you may not, matlab, this is just a rough calculation I have made, so you can follow this. Okay, so accuracy it may not be this, because every year the difficulty level it might be, or sometimes we get easy, sometimes we get difficult. But the important thing what I want to tell you, if you attempt, okay, if you attempt around 55 questions out of 80 questions, if you attempt 55 questions, if you 35 questions are right, and if you make around 20 questions wrong, then approximately you will reach the mark of 70 marks. So always have a target of which is of safer zone. Now, for example, he has told me, they have told me that 66.66 marks are to be taken by the candidate to qualify this paper. So don't keep 66 or 67 itself as the target. Okay, you have some good targets. Say, for example, I have just given you an example of 70, but still safer you can think of around 80, 90 or 100. Okay, even if we get 200 out of 200, we are not going to get the job. Okay, so after all, our mains paper is going to matter, our interview is going to matter in this examination. This paper is for qualifying nature. You see to it that in the examination you are very calm. Okay, because when we handle the subjects like maths, reasoning or English comprehension, our mind should be cool. And when our mind is cool, it works very powerful. And for that reason, what we have to do, whenever question paper is given to us, don't start with the first question itself. If first question is easy, then no problem, you start with the first question. But whenever you are in the examination hall, when you are starting with the paper, then always select those questions which are very easy for us. Because in the starting point, when we start the examination, we are a bit nervous. And when we are nervous, only those things come to our mind which are saved in the subconscious mind. Now, just now I told you one example, that there was the question asked that A into B is 21 and A plus B is 10. This question was asked in previous year in the form of data sufficiency. There were two statements given. So these questions, we are doing this since from our childhood, such type of questions. And these questions don't need any special trick or any special type of thinking. So these questions can be solved within few minutes, within few seconds you can say. So start with such questions. And definitely every year such type of questions, not only like this, but easier questions are being asked, whether it is from maths, reasoning or English. So these type of questions, when you start solving, when you start solving easier questions, automatically what will happen, you will become cool. And there will be a confidence in you, okay? And when you become confident, then the questions which are bit difficult, at that time you will be able to solve those questions also. Okay, this is how you need to do in the examination. Okay, and see to it that you don't attempt all the questions. Okay, so that if you don't know the answer, if you don't have any idea of that question, it is better to leave that question instead of marking any of the answer. So dear students, this was a small introduction about CSAT. I hope this information is useful for you people. On behalf of Classic team, I wish each and every aspirant of UPSC a very best of luck. Thank you very much and have a great day.